we play for pride.
We play for those who came before us.
We play for the community.
We play together as one.
We are the Indians.
Yelling Georgia, Euro better suffocate me. Hold it down for country, leave them mothers up to shaded. Give a damn if silly sisters think I'm good or lucky payment. Tell them watch it, they don't want it, however they can get it. Told them about that Buddha chatter, y'all better go with it. Infiltrated mainstream, maintaining the same theme. Polo shirts and pink, can't even get them stains clean. Ain't too much I ain't seen. In between LaGrange and Athens, ups and downs, rights and lefts, all around me, planes is crashing. Anyhow, we read it now. The new South has arrived. These savages is finna eat and won't stop till they satisfied.
We played together as one.
You don't want to forget anything. You don't want to miss anything. You want to be perfect on that day. Because in life, you don't get a lot of chances to be a champion.
Everybody's feeling strange, never gonna be the same. Makes you wonder how the world keeps turning. Alive, learning how to live my life, learning how to pick my fights, take my shots while I'm still burning. Goodbye to all those rain clouds. Goodbye so long.
Boom! That'll make them say, ugh!
Watching you too, right inside your skin.
It's like I'm paranoid, looking up.
After a 2001 state championship, the Indians began their 2002 season at Joe P. D. McCullough Stadium against the Big Macs of Ken and McMillan. This year's team was looking to duplicate the success of seasons past. But after a dismal first half, the Indians regained their composure to score 21 unanswered points to edge out the Big Macs and begin their season at 1-0. The Indians' first road trip. They faced a newly established rival in the West Mifflin Titans. The ground game led the way for the Indian offense. While the defense held a speed-prone Titan offense to only 16 points on their home turf. The Indians came back off the road to tame a hot Greensburg-Salem Golden Lion football team. The Golden Lions couldn't stack up against the high-powered offense and the stingy defense of West Allegheny. The final score was an accurate representation of how well the Indians played as a team and the dominance they could have when they played together. The Indians opened up the 2002 conference play against a highly rated Hopewell Viking football team. The Indian community rallied together behind the players as they packed the brand new Tony Dorsett Stadium to see the number one ranked Hopewell Vikings face off against the West Allegheny Indians in a rematch of last year's WPIAL Class AAA championship game. This game would be the best game the fans would see in quite a while. Both teams exchanged defensive blows. As the end of the first half ended with a 0-0 tie. But as the second half rolled on, the Vikings threw a long touchdown pass to give them the lead. That was all that was needed for the Vikings as they would edge out the Indians 7-0. Back at home for homecoming 2002, coming off their first conference loss to Hopewell, the Indians were ready for their first conference win against a high-powered offensive Blackhawk football team. In Blackhawks' first two games, they averaged 30-plus points per game. The Indians' defense lived up to their reputation as they shut out the high-scoring offensive Blackhawk and earned their first conference win. After a big win against Blackhawk, the Indians came in to Newcastle to face off against the undefeated Hurricanes. The surprise rain hampered the Indians as it hurt both teams' passing game and effectively slowed down the Indians' running game. The end result was the Indians' worst defeat in 6 years and a hard loss to swallow. Youth Night. The Indians did not want to disappoint their upcoming stars as a scrappy Ambridge team enters Joe P. D. McCullough Stadium, hoping to upset the Indian team who had lost two of its last three games. The Indians would have no part of it. After the game was tied at 7-7, the Indians took control and ended the Bridgers' hope of an upset. Both the offense and defense kicked into gear and shut out the Ambridge team to regain their winning ways. The Indians felt it was time to make a statement as they faced off against the school's biggest rival, the Moon Tigers. The offense was running on all cylinders and racked up 42 unanswered points against the timid Tiger defense. As years passed, the Indians shut out the Tigers as they were embarrassed on their home field for the second year in a row by the Indians. Senior night, and the Indians' last game of the 2002 regular season. The Indians looked to rebuild an old and now renewed rival as they faced the Spartans of Montour. The highly favored Indians came out and dominated the uninspired Spartans as they won their final game at Joe P. D. McCullough Stadium. After the game, the seniors left their mark on their home away from home as they celebrated their win by sliding across the muddy gridiron. The Indians were looking to duplicate past playoff successes with yet another state championship run. The first step was their week three opponent, Greensburg Salem. Rematch of week three, the Indians looked to replicate their victory against the Golden Lions. The offense and defense came to play in a game thoroughly dominated by the Indians. They once again proved their winning playoff ways as they defeated the Lions for the second time this season and advanced to the second round of the playoffs. North Hills High School was the final scene as the Indians faced off against the Rams of Pine Richland in the semifinals of the WPIAL playoffs. Pine Richland was by far the toughest and the most talented team the Indians faced all year. But the Indians were up for the task. On their first offensive possession, they came out firing on all cylinders as it took the Indians only four plays to reach the end zone. The Indians were out to play tough defense. They held the Ram running attack to a few yards as a newly established defense worked effectively. The The Rams made adjustments of their own, scoring two touchdowns on passes from their highly recruited quarterback. This ended the half with Pine Richland leading by a touchdown, 14-7. The attitude at halftime was still positive and optimistic. The West Allegheny Indians knew they were a second half team. And with this group of players, nothing was ever out of reach. The Rams, on the other hand, had different ideas. The second half belonged to Pine Richland as they scored two more touchdowns against the West Allegheny defense. When all was said and done, the Indians found themselves on the losing end of the game and their 2002 season was over. But heads were held high as the Indians walked off the field for the last time together as a team. The Indians gave everything they had all throughout the season. Through thick and thin, the Indians stuck together. The West Allegheny Indians had a saying that was with them the entire season. And when it was all said and done, the 2002 Indians were, and always will be, together as one.
Jim D'Amico, number 9, wide out, free safety, emergency quarterback. Omaha is right there.
Ron Ajo's number 56, special teams.
Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit.
Deontay Henry, number 2. I had long walks on the beach, picking flowers, just having fun. If you want to reach me, you can reach me on my email address, www.dnice.com.
My name's Aaron Kylick, number 29. Special teams All-American, captain of the Yellow Beanie Crew.
A singer in a smoky room.
John Lieber, number 22, glorified soccer player.
For a smile they can share the night.
My name is Stephen Levine, 64. I'm a Scorpio. I like warm summer nights and long walks on the beach with Deontay.
Jared Matchett, 36, nose corner.
Searching in the night. Streetlights, people.
Leader, number 18, defensive back wide receiver.
Ron Miller, number 33, linebacker.
Cody Mullins, number 15, linebacker, fullback, straight from the woods of Clinton.
Everybody wants a thrill, paying anything to roll the dice, just one
man. Dave Mulvihill, number 55, guard.
Brad Ozanich, ostentatious lineman, University of West Allegheny.
Luke Palko, number 5, quarterback deep.
Dan Rosnick, number 65, All-State injured reserves.
Marshall Fancy, number 16, wide receiver UB. I'd like to give a shout out to MBK.
Tom Tinney, number 66, O-line, D-line.
Justin Wisett, number 47, kicking specialist.